Howard Cosell, and you talk about this in your book, Game Over, said that politics and sports should not mix.
Yeah, he was saying rule number one of the jockocracy is that sports and politics should not mix. And Howard Cosell was somebody who is very political as a person, and he was talking very specifically about the way, as he put it, the jockocracy would function, like the elevation of former players, like his hated broadcast mate Frank Gifford would be elevated to these heights as a former jock, and because he was a former jock, he's somehow given this platform to be able to speak out. And that the way that, and he was saying this really as a critic of the jockocracy, and this idea that if you wanted to speak about politics in this construct, you would find yourself isolated, you would find yourself iced out, and you would find yourself without a place in this world. So if you want to be somebody who is a sports commentator, if you want to be somebody who's an ex-athlete who wants to be a part of this world, or even if you're a current athlete who wants to use your Hyper Exalted brought to you by Nike platform to actually say something about the world, you will pay a price for that. And that is the rule of the jockocracy. And of course, we are watching this game this year, the shadow of Colin Kaepernick, the former San Francisco 49ers quarterback who I would argue has been colluded against to be kept out of the National Football League. His shadow looms so heavily over this game, and I could explain how if you like, but just because he violated the rule number one of the jockocracy about mixing sports and politics because he protested police violence and racial inequity during the national anthem by taking a knee. And because he did that, even though his last season he threw for 16 touchdowns and only 4 interceptions, he finds himself without a job in the NFL. And now for 2 years, he's been out of this ongoing collusion case against the National Football League. But for this year's game, for example, you had a ton of high-end halftime acts like Rihanna, like Cardi B. I don't know if that's the first time Cardi B has been mentioned on C-SPAN. I'd be very excited if I'm that trailblazer in that regard. Pink, otherwise known as Alicia Moore, all of these artists refused to play at the halftime show out of solidarity with Colin Kaepernick, and it created this kind of artistic picket line where it was very difficult for them to find musical acts who could actually come and play the halftime show, which has been this this sub-story. It's been such a story, actually. I called it a sub-story, like a subterranean story that isn't really being talked about with the Super Bowl, but it's such a big deal that this year the National Football League canceled their annual big press conference with the halftime acts because they were scared that groups like Maroon 5 were going to be pressured by the press to say, why are you performing when so many artists are saying they're not going to do this in solidarity with Colin Kaepernick?